break it and probably eat it himself. All right? And at this time, I hand it over to the man in charge. Oh, the woman in charge.
Sure. I appreciate it. I'll be on. Can you guys hear me? Yes? Okay. Sophomores, I am Mrs. Hickson. Hopefully you know me by now. I'm the counselor for alphabet G to O. Mr. Cantlin has the end of the alphabet, and Mrs. Johnson, who has the beginning, is working with another group today. We are going to go over scheduling. It's that time of year already, so we're going to give you kind of an overview of scheduling for your junior year. And then just like we did last year, we're going to kind of break out in smaller groups in your communities. Over the next week, we'll meet with you guys. We're using a new system this year. So instead of you guys marking everything paper and pencil, as we've done in the past, we're going to let you actually enter your own requests in PowerSchool. So one thing I would like you to think of before we meet with you this week, please know your PowerSchool login and how to access that. Because when we get you into the smaller groups, what's been taking the longest, because we just did the freshmen, so we kind of had a trial run with them, because this is new for us too. But the what took the longest was getting everyone logged into PowerSchool. So if you know your PowerSchool login and you know how to access that, that'll get us moving quickly and help us help you better when you're making your selections. So we're going to go over just kind of an overview today, and then we will, like I said, do more details when we meet with you in smaller groups. So we've been having communities work with you guys more on credits and knowing how many credits you have and knowing your requirements. So hopefully you're getting more and more familiar with that and that you know by now you need 42 credits to graduate. You have to pass your classes to earn your credits. You'll do English all 4 years. You have to have math 3 years in high school, so you have to earn 6 math credits while you're in this building, regardless of what you took at the middle school. Science, you'll do ICP or chemistry, biology, and 2 additional science credits. For social studies, you do world history as sophomores and U.S. history as juniors. Government and econ as seniors. Everyone does PE and health, and then the rest of your credits are from electives. So next year for English, you will have an additional option because as you become juniors and seniors, AP courses become available to you. Raise your hand if you've heard of AP courses. Are you guys familiar with that at all? So advanced placement courses that let you take an exam at the end of the year to potentially earn college credit. So you will pick regular English, honors English, or AP English. Your teachers do give us recommendations based on your current English grades. And if you are not an AB student in English, you're going to have a hard time in honors and AP English. Ultimately, the decision is going to be up to you, but that's something to consider. Social studies, you guys will do U.S. history. There is also an honors U.S. history. So if social studies is your strongest subject or you're in honors world history and doing really well, you might consider that. And there's also an AP U.S. history option as well. And again, we'll be getting recommendations from your social studies teachers. For science, the sequence goes ICP, biology, and then 2 additional credits. If you did honors, let's see, if you're in, what are you guys in right now? You're in biology this year. So if you're in honors biology, you will go to chemistry. If you are in, am I saying this right? If you're in regular biology. Okay, yeah, I'm mixing up. If you did honors biology, you may be in chemistry. If you're in biology, you can look at chemistry or the other science electives. There are a couple AP options, AP chemistry and AP bio. We have physics and chemistry, and then we have some single trimester courses, anatomy, genetics, zoology, environmental, and astronomy. And then we have all of Mrs. Woodard's Project Lead the Way biomed series if you're interested in science in the medical field. AP Chem and AP Bio are offered on alternating years. This year we have bio, so next year will be AP chemistry. Math sequence, algebra, geometry, algebra 2, and then you can move into pre-cal or trig and stat, and we have AP calculus and AP statistics available. Again, you have to take 6 math credits in high school, even if you earned algebra or geometry while you were in middle school. So you'll move through that sequence in order regardless. And then the rest of your classes come from electives. Did you guys should have gone over an elective PowerPoint in your class? Did you do that and checked some, like on a little half sheet of paper, checked some ideas? We had you do that because we put them all in order the same way you're going to see them on PowerSchool. So when we go into, for you guys to enter your classes in community, when you have your half sheet, you should be able to just find the department that you marked your choices in, find them on PowerSchool, and then just enter those into PowerSchool. Again, as always, we remind you, choose wisely. We don't let you make schedule changes after school starts for a number of reasons. But you should know that when you pick your electives and your alternates, you know, there's a good chance that you could get some of those alternates, so they're important too. So you need to be making wise choices, things you're actually interested in when you're choosing your electives. And I'm going to hand this over to Mr. Cantlin.
So as juniors, you guys have the option to start taking some off-campus classes. We have a number of CTE programs that are off-campus. Our CNA program, Criminal Justice, Building Trades, Landscape, Fire Rescue, and EMT. Now, not all of these courses run every single year. They're all based on numbers. I will tell you, in the last couple years, we have not had a landscape program because we haven't had enough students in the county. And these courses are determined not just by the number of Frankfort students that select them, but also the number of students from Rossville, Prairie, and Central. So we haven't had a landscape program. Fire and rescue, we have had the numbers for, but we don't currently have an instructor, so we are looking for an instructor. So that may be a program that if you're interested in, definitely mark it, but we may not have that option if we cannot find an instructor. In that situation, EMT is a great substitute option for you. These programs will all lead to some kind of a certification that will allow you to go out and get a job right away. You'll be a trained emergency medical technician or a trained certified nursing assistant. Criminal justice, you get dual credits in, so you can't go out and become a police officer necessarily with criminal justice, but you will get 12 Vincennes credits to be able to continue with a criminal justice program if you want to continue with that after high school. Building trades, we have a house down on Mash Road that our building trades class builds. So if you're interested in any of these, some of them do have some prerequisites. So being in intro to construction is a good course to have taken before you get into building trades. But any of these are options, so you definitely want to mark these if you are interested in any of them. Pathways is another area that we need to talk about for your class. So you guys take ISTEP. The state has changed some things with the graduation model that does not necessarily affect you, but you can opt into it. And we're not going to go into all of the details with it, but Pathways is kind of the focal point of that. Pathways, you guys have all started a pathway. Whether you know it or not, you've all started a pathway because you've taken Preparing for College and Careers. So Preparing for College and Careers is the initial class into any pathway that we offer here at Frankfort. And then from there, the pathway leads into basically taking other courses in a defined area. We have a number of areas with pathways. These are all the areas that we have pathways in. And where it comes into play with you guys and what you guys need to know with regard to pathways is you need to start selecting a pathway right now. It's going to become more and more prevalent with the classes behind you. But if you have not kind of decided an area that you want to focus on for what you want to study after school or what you want to do as a career after high school, your classes, the classes that you select right now going into your junior year, are going to be important to help you progress into that. Because the more classes we can get you, the more certifications we can get you, the more dual credits we can get you, the better off you're going to be once you graduate in most cases. Okay? So we have pathways in all these areas. It's something that we will talk to you about when we meet with you individually for scheduling. And then the other piece that you need to know is, in the event you guys will all take ISTEP, you've taken the first round, you'll take the second round. Well, you haven't taken the first round yet, but you'll take ISTEP this year. ISTEP is your graduation qualification. But in the event that you don't pass ISTEP, we can talk about pathways as an option for you to move into graduation or move through graduation even if you don't pass the I-STEP. So this is going to be important, and it's something that we will talk to you more about when we meet with you individually. So we talked about the Core 40 diploma already. That is the main diploma that we have, 42 credits, and we talked about all the requirements for that. The Academic Honors Diploma is another diploma option for you. We have two other options for you with the Academic Honors Diploma. It requires 47 credits. You have to have two additional math credits, and that's where we can go back. If you took algebra and or geometry in the middle school, we can go back and use those as your 8 total credits required for the Academic Honors Diploma. It requires 6 to 8 credits in a foreign language, 2 fine arts credits, a C or better in all of your classes, and a 3.0 GPA. It also requires that you take a combination of either 2 AP classes or 6 dual credit classes, or a combination of 1 AP and 3 dual credits. And 1 dual credit class typically equals 3 college dual credits, okay? And again, we'll talk more about that when we meet with you individually, if the honors diploma is something that you want to go after. The technical honors diploma is similar to that. It doesn't have as many academic requirements. It still requires 47 credits. You still have to have a C or better, and you still have to have a 3.0. But this, again, and we've talked a little bit for some of you that have already said a technical honors diploma is the direction that you want to go, it requires pathways as well. So we can talk about those as options in your individual meetings also. We talked a little bit about this, too, with I-STEP. Your class is required to pass both the English and math portions for I-STEP. And then if you fail either portion, there will be opportunities to earn a waiver through various different options. So you may end up having to take a math lab or an English lab. We'll put those back into your schedule. Or we can talk about pathways possibly as an option as well if you've started down that route with some of the classes that you've already selected. Summer school is something that we will also talk about with your individual meetings. So if you have not received credits, if you haven't passed core classes in math, science, social studies, and English, then summer school is something that you're definitely going to need to think about. We have 2 options for summer school. We have early summer school that starts in April. It's after school that goes through May and our Maymester. And then we also have regular summer school that takes place in June. Then finally, just another reminder to choose your classes wisely. So you guys have all received the sheets, and you've all worked on selecting some of your electives. When we go into the computer lab and we start meeting with you guys as communities and putting your selections into the computer, you will have a certain number of classes already selected for you. So we will already have manually entered all of your English classes, all of your social studies classes, all of your math classes. I don't think we put science classes in there, so you'll select your science classes, and then you'll select your electives. You cannot go in and change any of the options that we've already put in for you. So if you are planning on taking honors or AP English, it's going to show up as just regular English 11. So that's something that we will not change when we meet as a community group. You guys don't need to change that. We will go back and change that during your individual meeting, okay? So when we get in there, any of the things that you show on your screen when we go to schedule, don't change anything that's already there. We're only going to add to those things. And then we will change everything else when we get into it and meet with you individually. When you meet to put in your classes, you will get a total of 15 credits. And then you'll select 3 alternates. On the sheet, we ask you to put 6 down because 3 sometimes isn't enough. But you'll understand when we go in to select the 3 alternates that asking you to actually select 6 alternates is going to be a little bit tough. So, and normally the computer will find a way to get one of those 3 in. If not, we'll get that filled, and we'll meet with you to take care of that. We meet starting tomorrow with your community groups. So your communities, your teachers have a schedule. So they'll bring you down to either room 129 or 131 today, or starting tomorrow, Thursday, and I think next Tuesday to get you time with us so that you can schedule. And then again, schedule changes. We're going to change the way that we do schedule changes a little bit. So in May, we will have a form that you can come down and get from Student Services that if you want to make a schedule change to anything that you've put into the computer, you can fill that out. You're going to need to take that home and get it signed by a parent and then bring it back to us. And then once we are at a point where we can start making schedule changes, we will start inputting those changes, okay, if they're possible. So sometimes those changes aren't possible. If they're not possible, we will try to talk to you before school's out, or we'll talk to you early on. You can come down and ask us why that change wasn't made. But sometimes, depending on where we're at in the process, we may not be able to get to schedule changes until summer. And so if a change that you request isn't made, just come see us either the week before school starts or the day school starts, and we can go over that with you. Does anybody have any questions? Does everybody know your PowerSchool login? Yes, no? Okay. When we meet with you, we have your PowerSchool logins, so we will have those. If you can figure it out or if you know what it is, please make sure that you have that information with you when we get there, because it'll just speed the process up. With the freshmen, it's taken the full community time, so I expect that it'll probably take the full amount because you guys have a little bit more to select than what the freshmen had. So we'll need to get in and get started as quickly as possible. So if you can figure out or you can find out what that login is, please try to do so. Otherwise, like I said, we will have your login attached to your elective sheet that you have filled out and turned in. Or if you haven't filled out and turned it in, we will still have your login. We'll just get it passed out to you. If you did not turn in your electives sheet, please be sure that you bring that to the meeting for your community class with you so that you have something to go off of. Otherwise, you're gonna have a little bit more to do, a little bit more work, problem solving. Bring your devices to the meetings as well. We will probably try to put everybody on a desktop computer, but sometimes we may have too many kids, so we'll ask some kids to use their devices. Otherwise, we will see you guys tomorrow again in your communities. Have a great day.